Hello everyone, welcome to this session on muscles of the upper limb. In this session we'll be learning about the muscles of the anterior compartment. In this compartment there are 5 superficial muscles and 3 deep muscles. The 5 superficial muscles are pronator teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, then flexor carpi ulnaris, then flexor digitorum superficialis, and the corresponding muscle in the deep aspect is flexor digitorum profundus. Then flexor pollicis longus is the muscle to the thumb. Then there's a muscle for pronation. The name is pronator quadratus. Okay. So 5 superficial and 3 deep muscles. Total in all 8 muscles we'll be learning in this particular session. So let's start with the superficial muscles first. The first muscle in the list is pronator teres. As we all know, any muscle when we study it under these headings. So we'll cover all these headings for each of the muscle. So proximal attachment for pronator teres muscle is, it actually has got two heads of origin. One head of origin is from the medial epicondyle of the humerus, that is also referred to as common flexor origin. And another one more head for pronator teres is the medial margin of the olecranon process of the ulna. Okay, they are the two heads of origin, and distal attachment is on the lateral aspect of the radius. Middle one third of the lateral surface of the radius below the attachment of supinator muscle. Then nerve supply of pronator teres is median nerve, and actions of pronator teres is it will cause pronation of the forearm. Okay. One important thing with respect to pronator teres muscle is the median nerve passes between two heads of pronator teres muscle. This is one important thing which you should remember. Now let's start with the flexor carpi radialis muscle. Flexor carpi radialis, also proximal attachment is from the medial epicondyle of the humerus. If you see all the 5 muscles, 5 superficial muscles, they will have proximal attachment from the medial epicondyle of the humerus because it is also referred to as common flexor origin. Okay, so all 5 superficial muscles will have attachment from the medial epicondyle of the humerus. Then distal attachment for flexor carpi radialis is, it is along the base of the second and the third metacarpals. Okay, palmar aspect of the base of the second and the third metacarpal is the distal attachment. Nerve supply is again median nerve, and action of flexor carpi radialis is it will cause flexion at the wrist joint acting along with flexor carpi ulnaris. Okay, and it has got one more action, that is abduction of the wrist joint. It acts along with extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis to cause abduction at the wrist joint. Okay, it will cause abduction at the wrist joint as well as it will cause flexion at the wrist joint along with flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Okay, so this was about flexor carpi radialis muscle. Then palmaris longus muscle, again proximal attachment is on the medial epicondyle of the humerus. Then distal attachment is it is attached here on the flexor retinaculum as well as it continues distally to get attached onto the palmar aponeurosis. Okay, the apex of the palmar aponeurosis. Nerve supply of palmaris longus is again median nerve, and action of palmaris longus, it is a weak flexor of the wrist joint. Okay, it is a degenerating muscle. At times 10-20% of the population it is absent. Now let's cover the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Flexor carpi ulnaris has also got two heads of origin. One is from the medial epicondyle of the humerus and other is from the medial margin of the olecranon process. Okay, it has also got some attachment from the posterior border of the ulna. Okay, by the deep fascia which is attached onto the posterior border of the ulna. Then distal attachment of flexor carpi ulnaris, if we see, it will be seen attached onto the pisiform bone, and from the pisiform there are two ligaments, pisohamate and pisometacarpal ligament, through which it gets attached onto the base of the fifth metacarpal bone. Okay, the pisiform bone is actually a sesamoid bone which develops under the tendon of flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Then actions of flexor carpi ulnaris, it will cause flexion at the wrist joint acting along with flexor carpi radialis, and it will cause adduction at the wrist joint acting along with extensor carpi ulnaris. Okay, let's cover the flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. This muscle has also got two heads of origin. one head is referred to as the humero ulnar head, arising from the medial epicondyle of the humerus as well as from the medial margin of the olecranon, and another head is radial head, which arises from the anterior oblique line of the radius. This is the anterior oblique line of the radius. Radial head arises from the anterior oblique line of the radius. And if you see the distal attachment goes up to the middle phalanx. Okay. Its tendon splits at the level of the proximal phalanx to get attached onto the sides of the middle phalanx. Okay. This one is middle phalanx. This is distal phalanx. This is proximal phalanx. It splits at the level of proximal phalanx, but ultimately it gets attached onto the sides of the middle phalanx. Action of flexor digitorum superficialis is it will cause flexion of the digits along the proximal aspect, proximal interphalangeal joint, as well as it will cause flexion at the wrist joint. So this was just a brief overview of all the five muscles. Now we'll see some dissected images of these muscles. So now let's try to identify all the muscles in this dissected image. Here, this point, as we all know, this is the medial epicondyle of the humerus. The medial epicondyle of the humerus is also referred to as common flexor origin. So most of the muscles, they arise from here. So this muscle which we can see here, this is the pronator teres muscle running obliquely. It will get attached onto the lateral aspect of the radius. Then this muscle which we can see, this is flexor carpi radialis muscle. And this small tendon which we can see, this is the palmaris longus muscle. And this muscle which you can see, this is the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Flexor digitorum superficialis is not seen here, it's seen clearly in this image. Okay, this muscle is flexor digitorum superficialis. So these are the five superficial muscles on the anterior compartment of forearm. Now let's cover the deep muscles. So there are three deep muscles: flexor digitorum profundus, flexor pollicis longus, and pronator quadratus. Let's start with flexor digitorum profundus. Proximal attachment of flexor digitorum profundus, it is on the anterior surface as well as medial surface of the ulna. Okay. Most of the anterior surface and medial surface of the ulna is occupied by flexor digitorum profundus muscle, and distal attachment, if you see, it goes up to the distal phalanx, okay, base of the distal phalanx of medial four fingers. Okay, flexor digitorum superficialis goes only up to the middle phalanx of medial four fingers. Digitorum profundus goes up to the distal phalanx. Okay, it is an exclusive flexor of the distal interphalangeal joint. Nerve supply of flexor digitorum profundus muscle is, it has got a dual nerve supply. Medial half is supplied by the ulnar nerve and lateral half is supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch of median nerve. Action, as I have told, it is a exclusive flexor of the distal interphalangeal joint. Also, it can cause flexion of the metacarpophalangeal as well as the wrist joint. Okay. Then flexor pollicis longus muscle. Flexor pollicis longus, here we can see, it arises from the anterior aspect of the radius below the anterior oblique line. Distal attachment is, it goes up to the base of the distal phalanx of the thumb. Okay, base of distal phalanx of the thumb is the distal attachment of flexor pollicis longus muscle. Action of flexor pollicis longus, it will cause flexion of the distal interphalangeal joint as well as it will cause mild flexion at the wrist joint. Nerve supply is, again, anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch of median nerve. Now let's cover the pronator quadratus muscle. Pronator quadratus, proximal attachment is from the ulna and distal attachment is on the radius. Because as we all know, in supination and pronation, the radius is the bone which moves. Ulna is the stable bone. Okay. So usually origins are from the stable bone and insertion is on the bone which moves. Okay. So proximal attachment is on the ulna, distal attachment is on the radius. Nerve supply is anterior interosseous nerve and action is pronation of the forearm. This was about the three deep muscles. Now let's see some dissected images of these muscles. So in this image, The flexor uterum superficialis muscles has been cut to expose the flexor digitorum profundus muscle. This muscle which is marked here, this is flexor digitorum profundus, and this muscle which is marked here, this is flexor pollicis longus. Okay, so this is flexor pollicis longus, this is flexor digitorum profundus, and in this image we can see this is pronator quadratus. Okay, arising from the ulna, distal attachment is on the radius. Now let's summarize what we have covered in this particular session. So we started off with the five superficial muscles: pronator teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor carpi ulnaris, and flexor digitorum superficialis. Amongst these five, four are superficial. Flexor digitorum superficialis is slightly in an intermediate plane, and in deeper planes there are these three muscles. Okay. So almost all the muscles have got proximal attachment from the medial epicondyle of the humerus, that is referred to as common flexor origin. Pronator teres has got an additional head from medial margin of the olecranon process. Also, flexor carpi ulnaris and flexor digitorum superficialis, they also have attachments on the medial margin of the olecranon. Okay, so these muscles have two heads of origin, and distal attachment of pronator teres is on the lateral aspect of the radius. For flexor carpi radialis, distal attachment is on the base of the second and the third metacarpals. For palmaris longus, it goes up to the palmar aponeurosis. For flexor carpi ulnaris, attachment is on the pisiform bone, through which it extends onto to the hamate and the base of the fifth metacarpal by pisohamate and pisometacarpal ligaments. Then flexor digitorum superficialis goes up to the middle phalanx. Okay, it splits at the level of proximal phalanx, gets attached onto the middle phalanx of the medial four fingers. Nerve supply, if we see, all muscles are supplied by median nerve except flexor carpi ulnaris. Flexor carpi ulnaris is supplied by ulnar nerve. Then actions of these muscles, almost all muscles, they will cause flexion at the wrist joint. Additionally, flexor carpi radialis can cause abduction of the wrist joint. Flexor carpi ulnaris can cause adduction at the wrist joint. And flexor digitorum superficialis will cause flexion of the proximal interphalangeal joint. Okay, then now let's see the deep muscles. These are the three deep muscles: flexor digitorum profundus, proximal attachment is on the anterior aspect of the ulna as well as the medial surface of the ulna. Distal attachment is it goes up to the distal phalanx of medial four fingers. Action, it is an exclusive flexor of the distal interphalangeal joint, as well as it can cause flexion of the proximal joints which it crosses. Nerve supply, flexor digitorum profundus is a hybrid muscle which has got dual innervation. The medial half is supplied by the ulnar nerve, the lateral half is supplied by anterior interosseous nerve. Flexor pollicis longus, proximal attachment is on the radius, anterior aspect of the radius below the anterior oblique line. Distal attachment is on the distal phalanx of the thumb. Nerve supplies anterior interosseous nerve. Action it will cause flexion of the thumb. Pronator quadratus, it has attachment on proximal attachment on the ulna, distal attachment is on the radius, lower one fourth. Nerve supplies anterior interosseous nerve, and action is pronation of the forearm. Okay, so this was all about this particular session. In the subsequent session, I'll be covering the muscles of the extensor compartment of the forearm. Okay, thank you.